So my name is Chun-Ti Chen. I'm a postdoc in Marc-Jan Gubbels Lab at Boston College. So as you may know already, our lab work on the lytic cycle of unicellular parasite called Toxoplasma gondii. And I'm specifically interested in understanding how parasites divide inside the host cell. So I'm originally from Taiwan. I came to US in 2013 and I went to UMass Medical School. I was working with the mitotic exit of Schistosaccharomyces pongii. And I met Dr. Gubbels in a party. And he was working with a protein that I was working in pongii, in toxo. So we talked in the party, and then that's about the time when I was about to graduate. So we exchanged information, and then he invited me here for a job interview. And I think switching my study from pongii cell cycle regulation to toxo cell cycle regulation could be a fascinating thing, because toxoplasma, I think, it comes with a very unique structure, and then I can appreciate the beauty of this organism, so that I want to explore more of this. So I have my own project.
You do a lot of work.
I come to the lab and then I design experiments and then see what this experiment can tell me, like what sort of the parasite do or without this gene, what the parasite will respond to that. So knowing the fact that the thing you're looking at right now, you are the only person in the world seeing this phenomenon just happening underneath the thing you're looking at, this idea fascinates me most.
So I have,
So people in our lab, we have different projects. So we try to figure out different biological questions regarding this parasite, but we took different approaches and then try to come up with a big picture of what's going on in this parasite, how they invade, how they replicate in the parasite, how they get out. So the overall goal is to know how parasites replicate, because the disease that caused by Toxoplasma gondii is called toxoplasmosis, and the severity of this disease all depends on the how fast and then how much the parasite replicate in the cells. So the more it replicates, the more severe damage it caused in humans. So if we can find a way to stop the replication, maybe that will hopefully slow the progress of the disease or kill the parasite, stop it from replicating in humans. You always have to challenge yourself, because I think science is like you bring up some ideas, but you have to keep challenging and make sure that this could be something that may be very close to the truth, because all the experiment we do is like in vitro. This is that we set up this hypothetical scenario, but it might not be true. So you have to keep challenging this idea. And you might be right, you might be wrong, but you always have to keep moving forward. And then you want to make sure that you really like what you're doing and you know where you are going. Science could be fun, but sometimes it might kill you. Yeah.